ADSL was released in the United Kingdom in the year 2000. The rollout was gradual, and by the year 2003 was widely available, marking the transition from dial-up internet to broadband. Before hardware firewalls became the norm, a DrayTek router and a Microsoft ISA server were among the most popular setups for a UK business. Hi, it's Kyle, and today we're going back to the early 2000s when I was in my 20s and SharePoint was a new thing. Networks were mostly on-premise and the cloud was something that got in the way of your holiday in Benidorm. We're talking about ISA Server 2004, Microsoft's enterprise-grade firewall that was included in the small business server package and a product that I installed across all of my clients at this time. We're going to dig into the history of that product today. And then in the next video, I'll take you through how I actually configured and used it on a small business server. Now, let's get into the backstory of ISA Server 2004. Before ISA Server, firewalls were almost always hardware devices. Common examples were the WatchGuard Firebox 2, Cisco PIX, SonicWall Soho, and perhaps the most commonly found in the UK business, the Vigor 2200 from DrayTek. These devices were good at filtering network traffic. They operated at layers 3 and 4 of the OSI model, filtering by source and destination IP address, source and destination ports. The problem was they didn't know who the user was on the computer or what applications they were using. Integration into the domain was rudimentary. NTLM and Radius was available, but they still generally required the user to enter a username and password in a dialog box. Possibly the closest to achieving fully transparent access rules was the WatchGuard Firebox. The Firebox could redirect each user when they opened their browser to a login page where they could enter their domain credentials. This meant the admin could have authentication for users to go onto the internet and also get reports on which sites and services the users were accessing. It was definitely a step forward for small businesses because at this point in time, the only product that could truly compete against this was the Checkpoint Firewall 1 product. However, that product initially cost between £8,000 and £15,000 per instance, and naturally was completely out of range for any UK small business. This is where Microsoft saw the opportunity. They already owned the server room with Microsoft Exchange, Microsoft SQL Server, and Active Directory. The next logical step, released their own enterprise-grade firewall product. This was ISA Server 2004, a truly enterprise-grade firewall. Yes, they included it in small business server. Before we dig into the details, let's get a little bit of history on the ISA server products. Microsoft's journey into internet security began in January 1997 with the launch of Proxy Server 1.0. Built for Windows NT 4 and known internally as Catapult, it marked the company's first step toward protecting networks at the enterprise level. This is really where the story of ISA server begins. Proxy server was, by definition, a proxy. You pointed your browsers at it, and it improved the speed of browsing the internet for users, which could be shared over a network. But it wasn't anywhere near a security product yet. It was the first step that Microsoft took towards arranging and organizing security for a business.
At this time, most small businesses were using one computer in the corner of a room with a dial-up modem to access the net. Then came Proxy Server 2.0 later that year in December. A bit more advanced, better NT authentication, and support for multiple protocols and packet filtering.
I first used this when it arrived in Back Office Server 4.0 in January 1999.
It was usually coupled with an ISDN card in those days. Two channels, 64-bit, enabling you to get 128 megabits download speed. It really was the first time that employees in businesses had access to the internet from their desktops. But still, it wasn't what you call a security product. It was really offering PAT translation with built-in NT authentication. It was a sign of what was coming though. Microsoft was laying the groundwork for something much bigger. In March 2001, Microsoft released ISA Server 2000. It came in standard and enterprise editions, required Windows 2000, and would later run on Windows 2003 server.
Now system administrators had a full firewall, a web proxy caching server, and a VPN device all in one product.
It wasn't just packet filtering, it could actually inspect traffic, publish internal websites securely, and integrate directly with Active Directory.
ISA Server 2000 really transformed how an administrator handled internet access. Everything was in Windows in the GUI. you could use Active Directory users and groups to simplify access, servers could be published by using wizards, and there was no complex or arcane command lines or CLI to learn for the administrator. It was a powerful product, but it wasn't perfect. The new GUI was the MMC in Windows 2000, which meant you had to learn a different way of using applications from the previous way an application looked in Windows NT 4 Server.
Understanding rules around publishing was complex at times. It introduced SSL certificates to many system administrators for the first time, but despite the learning curve, it gave Microsoft administrators a true security tool that could compete with Cisco and Checkpoint.
ISA Server was released in September 2004. It came in Standard and Enterprise Edition, and it was licensed on a per processor basis. The Small Business Server Edition was licensed for two processors.
Some manufacturers made hardware appliances that ran a cut-down version of Windows with ISA Server on them. These were quite popular, as they very much mimicked what system administrators were used to in a hardware firewall appliance. Multiple core features had been upgraded, including how it integrated with Active Directory, the overall look and feel of the GUI, and an impressive change in the wizards simplifying complex firewall structures. You could now add DMZ networks that had never been available before. This means an administrator could place an Exchange server or a web server in the DMZ, increasing the security posture of the overall network. Routed and NAT traffic could be separated, meaning you could enable traffic to bypass NAT for destinations such as VPN tunnels, and protocols could be allowed over VPN, but not over NAT. For the first time, an administrator could filter at layer 7 of the OSI model,
allowing them to inspect the contents of protocols such as HTTP and SMTP for policy violations and malicious traffic. This far surpassed the capabilities of ISA Server 2000. The VPN quarantine feature enabled an administrator to check whether a Windows client had up-to-date antivirus definitions and a certain amount of Windows updates before they were allowed to connect to the network. This provided a security posture that had not been available to administrators before. This was a massive step forward for VPN administrators. Previously, you would have had no idea whether a computer connecting to your network had any antivirus or had any patches installed in the operating system. Now the administrator could confidently allow someone to connect with a laptop they hadn't seen before into the network, knowing that they would have to meet certain criteria, such as the antivirus product and such as a level of Windows updates, before they were granted access to systems behind the firewall.
Perhaps the most significant security feature, and the one that foreshadowed the world's future in the next 10 years, was URL scan. This was an ISAPI filter that extended the ability of Internet Information Services in Windows. URL scan was able to intercept traffic and examine commands to make sure that they would meet a specific set of rules. Post and get would be allowed to a web server, but put and delete would not be allowed. Specific file extensions could be blocked. There are maximum lengths for URLs and characters in order to avoid buffer overflow attacks.
By using SSL bridging, you could intercept SSL traffic, decrypt it, inspect it, re-encrypt it, and hand it off to the user, allowing inspection of even HTTPS traffic to be completed.
Broadband was pretty widespread by 2004 and 2005. However, speeds were usually between 512 kilobits and 2 meg downstream, meaning that the caching features of ISA Server 2004 were still important to businesses. Traffic could be pre-cached and downloaded, providing a faster experience for users and employees.
Because ISA Server 2004 was included in the Small Business Server, it really began the process of small business servers hosting their own Exchange servers, publishing SharePoint sites, and offering ways of working remotely through remote web workplace or VPN solutions.
In early 2005, Bill Gates was asked by the BBC about security and why Microsoft didn't take that threat seriously enough. Bill famously replied, "Certainly we can always do better. It's the top priority." ISA Server 2004 was the epitome of this statement and showed Microsoft was taking internet security very seriously. The final version of Small Business Server to include ISA Server was Windows Small Business Server 2003 R2 Premium Edition, released in July 2006. This included ISA Server 2006, the final version of the product to carry the ISA brand. At a corporate enterprise level, the product continued, changing its name to Forefront Threat Management Gateway 2010. Support ended in 2015, and extended support ended in 2020. For most small businesses, the natural path was to upgrade to Small Business Server 2008, which was released in November 2008. However, this version no longer included the ISA server, ending the era of the enterprise firewall being included for small businesses. The IT world had started to move on. Unified threat management devices and next generation firewalls were becoming the predominant devices. The Cisco ISA, Fortinet FortiGate, and SonicWall TZ series led this change. In September 2012, Microsoft officially ended the development of their firewall product lines. ISA Server and TMG quietly faded into the annals of history.
Looking back, ISA Server was way ahead of its time. It blurred the lines between what was application and network security. You might say even it introduced the concept of a firewall at layer 7 and zero trust to many small business and system administrators. If you've enjoyed this video history of ISA Server, then give me a subscribe, it'd mean a lot to me. In the next video, we're going to get into Small Business Server 2003 with ISA Server 2004 installed, and I'm going to take you through how I used the product to solve specific problems that commonly came up in a small business. I'll see you on the next video. Ta-da!